Hey guys, so this week I found myself talking a lot about posture. Why not talk some more about posture? My experience teaching posture has been kind of interesting. Normally you would think that, you know, because I have learned posture this way or I have discovered that this posture works better for me, that you would want to pass that on to your students, right? When I first started teaching posture, it was really weird because I would try to tweak my students' posture and I tried to move them so that they look like me. But whenever I would kind of like make them play it the way I did, their arm just doesn't bend that way or their thumb just doesn't straighten out. You know, you tweak one thing and then everything else goes out of alignment. It was really confusing as a teacher to see my students reacting that way because like every time I would teach them how to hold the instrument, their posture looked better, but it was clear that they were very uncomfortable. A lot of them actually told me they were straight up in pain. That's one of the most confusing things to happen to you is when you try to teach your students the right thing, but they tell you that as a result of doing that right thing, they are literally in pain. That feels bad. It took me many years of just observing my students' postures. I actually did let quite a few of my students just hold the flute however was comfortable to them, and I didn't correct them for a very long time because I was so scared of making them be in pain. I avoided it for a really long time until a light bulb went off fairly recently, actually. It suddenly occurred to me what the common denominator was for good posture. So that's what I wanted to talk about today. You may or may not have heard by now, if you are watching this video, of the three-point balance system. Essentially, it's just that you have 3 points on your body with which you are balancing the flute. The first point is here. Chin. The second point is the side of your index finger. For some people, it rides higher on their index finger, and for some people, it rides lower. It depends on how long your finger is. And then the third point is your thumb. Now, ideally, you should be able to just hold the flute out like this without pressing any of the keys, including the pinky, including this thumb. Look, Ma, no keys! If you can balance it like this, then that means you can play anything. You won't feel the flute rocking back and forth. The way that I feel for me, my chin is gently balancing the flute and pushing the flute away from me. My index finger, it feels like it's sort of pushing against it at an angle upward, and my thumb kind of feels like it's pushing against the flute at a slight angle upward the opposite way. Now, the exact angles of these 3 points I'm noticing now is actually slightly different person to person, but generally it is a 3-point balance system. I spent hours, I can't even tell you how many hours I spent in the mirror just kind of like holding the flute until I could get this 3-point balance. I know it, I make it look super easy just doing it like this, but it did take several hours for me to find that perfect sweet spot balance. Now, the second thing that I'm noticing is your right shoulder and what it's doing is very, very key to figuring out if your posture is working for you or not. You may notice if you watch like a lot of professional flutists, the angle at which they angle their flute varies wildly from professional to professional. So some professionals are like straight parallel to the ground, right? But other professionals, like you just like look up random videos of professional flutists playing and you'll see this. Some flutists will actually play like this. Like, holy crap, right? What even? But they're perfectly comfortable. They can play super well. I started to really observe why different people like are angling it at different angles. It occurred to me that I think it has to do with the length of your arms. If you have really long arms, you only have so much space for like the length of your arms. You would naturally hold the flute up more. The pure length of your forearm and your, your upper arm, the pure length of it will like naturally prop the flute up higher. If you have shorter arms like me, because I don't have enough arm, if I were to put my flute up all the way parallel, do you notice what happens to my shoulder? It like rides upwards. Suddenly I become very lopsided. So for me, I do actually have to angle the flute down some, but not like crazy much either. I'm sort of like average so that my two shoulders are even. There you go, you see that? Nice and even. The other part of your shoulder is what the muscle is doing next to your shoulder blade. You gotta do this with me, okay? So you gotta put your arm here so you can feel the muscle right next to your shoulder blade. What you wanna do is use your right arm and pull it back, and you can feel the muscle contracting. You pull it forward and you can feel it relaxing. You need to find for you, at which point does it completely relax? Your arm has to be at the same height as when you hold up a flute to do this. When you get to a point where it relaxes, that's where your hand needs to be. That's how far out you need to bring your elbow out. Usually when I tell students to do this, they'll just kind of like turn the whole torso with their flute, and I'm like, no, just move your arm, okay? So you're literally like rotating the flute out like this. Shoulders need to be even. The muscle next to your shoulder blade needs to be relaxed. For me, I end up playing like this. So it's a little bit pushed out and it's a little bit angled down because that is perfect for my body. So you have to figure out what works for you. And it does take a little bit of time to just kind of like experiment with it. For right hand posture, if I loosen up my hand, you'll notice nice and relaxed, right? Tuck my thumb away as if it doesn't exist, hold the flute up with the other arm, and then fit your relaxed fingers over the keys, okay? Then extend your thumb to where it naturally wants to go. You can see very clearly, I do not make contact with the flute. Therefore, I desperately need an extension, and the thumb port acts as a lovely extension for me. Boom! And then you have beautiful right hand posture. Now your left hand posture is really interesting because you can just look at professional flutists and see how wildly different their postures are actually. Your fingers need to be naturally curved. For me, the only way they can be naturally curved is if I give myself a little bit more height coming off of the flute. If I don't have it, I can't play with perfectly curved fingers because I don't have that height that I need to keep them curved. If I collapse it inward like this, the rest of my fingers also just kind of get really flat. Gotta experiment with that. See if you also collapse. If you don't also collapse like me, then you don't need this. You see that? Nice curve. This guy is just a piece of cork that's been glued on with cement glue. You can actually take it off really easily without hurting the metal. I am the type of person who, if I squeeze my index finger too much, it actually contracts that muscle next to my left shoulder blade. And if I do it too much, I give myself back pain. This was just added on to completely make that back pain go away because I am now no longer squeezing it all the way down. And there you have it. If you combine it all together, then you have this lovely posture. I can play anything I want, you know, I can reach all the keys without feeling like the flute's gonna roll away. Plus, I'm nice and relaxed, shoulders relaxed, shoulder blade muscles are relaxed as well. It's a good time. There you have it. I hope you guys found that helpful. Please do not copy my posture 100% because you might end up in pain. You need to find what works for you. I may update this in the far future again when I have another enlightening moment. Anyway, there you have it. So I hope you guys are having a lovely weekend so far. If you want to catch me on my social media, they're linked down below. You can hit subscribe if you want, but YouTube is broken, so hit that bell icon if you want to get notifications of when I post. This is last week's video, which I will put a link to up here for you guys. If you want to, you can come hang out with me on Patreon every other week, but otherwise, I'll see you guys next week. Bye. But if you're like me and you have like, oh. Yes, love, I'm filming. Okay. I'll stop rambling soon.